Colorado with Mr. Billy Nolan Lovelady. Mr. Lovelady, my name is Kenneth Wooten. I'm counsel for the Select Committee on Assassination for the United States House of Representatives in Washington, D.C. Do I have your permission, sir, to take this interview?
You sure?
All right, sir. Would you please tell me your full name?
Billy Nolan Lovelady.
And your current address, sir?
3488 South Kalispell, Aurora, Colorado.
And where did you live prior to your coming to Colorado?
Irving, Texas.
All right, sir. And on or about November the 22nd, 1963, where were you employed?
Texas Food Book Depository.
All right, sir. Would you tell me what happened, to the best of your recollection, at your home on the morning of November the 22nd, 1963? What time did you get up? What did you do?
I'd say we got up around 6:30, between 6:30 and 7 o'clock, and made prep, actually go to work, and left to catch the bus on the corner before we caught the bus to go downtown, so my car was out of commission, and we got downtown, I'd say, around 7:30. And I transferred bus to go to my work. My wife also sent things to go to her work. And I have to take school book and report at 8 o'clock in the morning.
All right, sir. Did your normal routine in the morning consist of showering and shaving in the morning, or did you shower and shave at night?
Shower and shave at night.
All right, sir. When you got home from work?
Yeah, or before you went to bed.
Before bed.
All right.
Now, do you remember how you were dressed that day?
I sure do.
All right, sir. Would you please describe whether you were wearing any glasses or not?
I do not wear glasses.
All right, sir. Did you wear any type of a t-shirt?
Yes. In the cotton, just a undershirt, t-shirt.
All right, sir. Do you recall what type of slacks you had on?
I wore blue jeans.
All right, sir. Do you recall what type of shirt you had on?
Just an ordinary work shirt. No.
All right, sir. Would you describe that shirt for me, please?
My other color, that's red and plaid shirt with the soft cotton, ordinary cotton plaid shirt.
Now, this is a photograph. It's a color Xerox copy of a photograph that was taken. Maybe you can tell me what it was taken by. With regard to CBS or somebody that did something?
It's
the shirt.
It was in or is
the picture.
All right, sir.
Let's initially, do you have that team? Let's initially just identify it, sure. Thank you.
has it been in your possession since that time, day one?
All right.
Now, you said you took the bus to work that day?
Yes, sir.
And you arrived at 8 o'clock?
Yes.
Was anyone with you?
No, I walked from the bus stop to the court.
All right, sir. And when you arrived at work, where did you report?
Just went inside the building and just thought, you know, if I wasn't exactly 8 o'clock, I might have had a cup of coffee or something like that for work.
Did you, was there a time card checking or anything like that?
Did you punch it in or anything like that?
You called it?
No.
What was the normal procedure for you to follow, or for all of the employees who got the necessary to follow when you reported for work? Who handed that out? Who made doing assignments and things like that? Did you have
we had a Simon Bell Kelly, and then Mr. Trier was over him, and we were held over, or at that day we were working on the sixth floor putting in a plywood plane to replace that one, because we had a lot of grease on it that come through the boxes and bolts and just stuff.
Now, who was working with you on the sixth floor that day? Do you recall?
There were several. There was Bonnie Ray Williams, Charles Gibbons, Wesley Frazier, and
So you watch the little short back to the door. Who was this the work assignment that you had had previously?
We had worked, I believe, some of that before. We were had one side of the flooring done already, and we had gotten to one side and moved books over.
Did your work deviate in any way, or was there any direction for you on that day to do anything different than what you'd done before?
I'm not so sure what I'm doing.
Okay. Did you notice anyone, how long had you been working, how many days had you been working up on the sixth floor?
Two or three, I know.
Alright. Did you notice during those two or three days, anyone you didn't know, or anyone that wasn't supposed to be up there?
No, sir.
Alright. Around the school book depository, or in the depository, did you notice any strangers coming in and going out?
Sure did not.
Okay. Now, on that morning then, you were laying this plywood with these other people.
Right.
Alright. And then what happened after that?
Now we worked till around 10 till 12.
Alright.
And we all got together and went down to freight elevators to get ready for lunch or go wherever. You know, the other guys, some went out, and some stayed, had their lunches, and we went down to the first floor to clean up and get ready for dinner.
All right. Now, when you were on the sixth floor, did you see Lee Harvey Absalom?
No, on the sixth floor.
All right. Did you see Lee Harvey Absalom at all that morning?
Yes, sure did.
All right.
He was working, filling orders just as usual. Working on the fifth and sixth floor, and you know, coming up elevator, same, filling orders.
All right. do you recall about what time you saw him that day?
It was the various times, but, you know, it was every time during the morning.
Right. And he was so nervous?
Yes.
Right. And that was on the 56th floor?
Yes.
Right. Do you recall how he was dressed on that day?
I believe he had blue jeans, just an ordinary tight work shirt and a t-shirt.
Did you see pictures of him after his arrest?
I sure did.
Was he dressed the same after his arrest as he was when he was at work?
Right. Sure was.
Okay. Now, did you follow, when you went on your lunch procedure, did you, was that the normal procedure that you usually follow?
Yes.
When you'd start about 10 or 12 and you didn't wash your
hair? Well, the elevators were very slow in time we all got through. Compared to what we were doing, you know, got through the elevators and then down to the first floor, and you know, maybe 5 or so, you know, still 12, and time you cleaned up, it'd be 12 o'clock. So,
all right,
we had 45 minutes to run.
Now, when you saw Lee Oswald, did he differently than he had acted any other time when you saw him?
No, sure didn't.
All right. Did he appear anxious or nervous or anything?
Not that I could tell.
Okay. When, about what time was the last time you saw him?
10 minutes or 12 on the first floor.
All right. And did he say anything to you?
Or to anyone that was with you? Not to me. They just told us there's one elevator that you can close the gate, and when you get to the bottom, you push a button, and it'll come back up. And
right.
He asked us if we would do this. And we had told him, no, we're going down and get ready for lunch, and it's quitting time, and just joking around when we got to know he wasn't going to do it. And he said, you know, come on down to let's go watch the parade. And he said, no, sir, it's a closed gate, and he went that way. They have some orders to fill.
All right. All right. Now, prior to the Kennedy assassination, did you and Lee Oswald have any discussions?
No, not any discussion. I'd ask him maybe how his little baby was with him, been maybe a couple months old or a month and a half, and he'd answer, and you know, that would be a
Did you ever discuss politics or anything?
Sure did.
All right. Did you ever discuss his travels with you?
No, sir.
All right. What were your observations about how he worked, and about his habits, and about his relationship to his other employees?
As far as his work, he did work just like, you know, just went about his own business, and he did not so much money for all this. And charge of stop, and I thought he may ask me, you know, where a book was or where a title of a book was, and I'd tell him, you know, and he's going to need a fill over just like Lewis would, but he'd ask him something, and he'd answer you, but he wouldn't give me further information. I'd send him shoot the bull with him, you know, and
how did he seem to get along with the people he worked with? From your observation,
which to me, a real quiet, you know, standoff, you know, kind of to his staff alone. And, bullcorn around with a guy, and I don't know, I didn't like him myself, and he never did nothing to me, but this type of, you know, telling me if we like or not.
Did you ever notice anything unusual about his actions, or anything that he isn't what you've already become. You know, what was the general appearance like? What person would he have been closest to at work? By closest, I mean, who, you know, who he was the friendliest with at work? First learned the President Kennedy was coming down.
Newspaper, yes.
Do you remember when that was?
I think it was day before, two days.
When was the, to your recollection, when was the news of the parade route first published in there?
Do you remember?
I don't know myself.
So, maybe I don't remember, reading the paper.
Do you recall any conversations of anybody in the Texas school book depository? On November the 22nd, 1963, or immediately before, about President Kennedy's visit. Now, tall a person are you? I'm 5'8" with shoes on. How much did you weigh then? You were tall?
Oh, I'm 60, 65.
What was the length of your hair?
I knew I had a crew cut.
You had a crew cut.
A balding crew cut.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's kind of important. You recall whether you had a crew cut. You had a crew cut then. All right. But you had, when was the last time you'd shaved? You recall that? Were you growing the beard at that time?
Wasn't growing the beard.
Was the last time you shaved, when was that again?
The night before.
4 or 5 hours. Alright. Okay. You're shaking your head, man.
If I could get him to shave twice a week, we're doing good.
Look at that chair, you go where I stayed.
I stayed every night, but then, no.
Okay.
He didn't have any carrots to keep up that he does now.
All right. Okay. I'm not trying to put words in your mouth. I mean, this is kind of, it's kind of important. Is it possible? Let me say that. You tell me what's your best estimate is about how long it had been before that to get shaved. Could have been 2 days.
Uh-huh.
Now, if you eat your lunch on the steps,
yes.
All right. Now, I've never been there. Where there's a railing down the middle.
Not just put in. Kind of thing.
All right. So you guys are in the steps on the head.
Okay.
All right. Did you sit down on the steps and eat your lunch?
Yes.
All right. Do you have your lunch bag with you? Did you pack your lunch?
Yes. My lunch, I had a coat.
Alright. Where would you purchase the coat?
Inside on the second floor.
Okay. And then you went outside and looked, what kind of lunch were you eating? You remember that?
Yeah, just a sandwich and a coat.
Do you know whether you had your lunch bag when the motorcade passed and the coat bottom, or had you eaten your lunch? From the west.
No, I just threw it out there where I
went. It was right there.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Would you describe for me, sir, what was going on in the steps with the people on the steps?
General talk and going on and waiting for the president to come by.
Okay. Yeah. That's the best recollection you had. Your lunch bag in your hand at the time. Where it was there.
I was sitting down, not having a step between the legs.
Was there anyone on those steps that you didn't recognize?
No.
Right. Were the people who were on the steps people from the school bus department?
Right. Employees at Tech School Bus.
Okay.
Different publishers.
Do you recall the people who were on there?
There's some. There's Wesley Sizer, Bill Shirley, Sarah Stanton, and some other ladies that worked upstairs.
All right. You recall which step you were on?
I was sitting on the first step when my feet ended. On the second or third step, putting on the main first platform.
All right. Did you see Lee Oswald around those steps?
No.
outside. Now, I'm going to move on to the second category of questions, which are the events at the time of the assassination. How many shots do you recall here? Three. Would you describe for me the sequence of shots?
There was one shot, a pause, then two passions.
All right. Now, did you hear any difference in the shots? I mean, I guess I'm asking you, did you notice any difference in the, like, one was louder than the other?
No, no.
All right. All right.
So that's something.
All right. But it was one shot and then two in more rapid succession.
Okay.
From what direction did you believe that those shots came from?
To my right.
All right. And where would that have been?
Around the corner. Well, as you come down the street, you have a blind spot. And, of course, you have to go down to the bottom to look around the corner. Now, it sounded like to my right toward the railroad track.
All right. Now, far away from you would that have been?
150, 200 yards.
All right. Where are the steps? I haven't been down there. Where are the steps in relation to the fifth window of that school book depository?
Almost directly above.
All right. Did you hear anything from up there?
No.
All right. Did you smell, I think you're familiar with the smell of gunpowder, did you smell anything?
No, I sure didn't.
All right. Now, did you see any smoke or anything?
No.
Coming from up there?
I could not see the window from where I was that anyway.
All right. All right. Did you see any smoke over by the railroad tracks you just
said? No.
All right. Did you see any flashes over there?
No.
But that's where you thought the shot came from.
Right.
What did you do when you heard the shot?
I thought if it was just somebody in the woods celebrating the parade of the president, it sounded kind of like maybe a loud firecrackers or something else. We were getting it all over the concrete.
Right.
And one of the girls that had been staying real close to the curb ran up to us and told us that the building had been hit.
Right. Now, do you recall who that person was?
Dora Calvert, I believe.
Okay. Right. What did you see?
Well,
you heard the shot.
Just a lot of people running towards the, I guess you could, a little more they call it, behind towards the right angle of the building, and a bunch of running towards the railroad track that led in behind that building.
All right. Are those the same railroad tracks that you described? In your opinion, the shots came from? Were they running in that direction?
Yeah.
All right. What did you see over in that direction?
People running and hollering and didn't know what was going on like that, though.
Do you recall who was standing next to you or anything like that?
Yes, they were standing, he and the staff, after the girl told us, about the president getting hit, and everybody started running towards the railroad track. We took off and started towards the railroad track. And I don't know why, just seeing around ourselves. And we got to about
two railroad tracks, and we went on what we were doing out there, and then we came into the back entrance of that building and came on back down in the building.
All right.
One policeman, Mr. ran up the staff goes,